On a typical day at John F. Kennedy Airport, there are thousands of people going hundreds of places.
Excuse me, sorry.
My battery keeps dying.
I'll borrow mine if you want.
But today, a girl and a boy will meet.
Sorry, I don't share electronics till the third date.
Okay. No, I suppose it is quite intimate.
And it will change everything.
Hello, ladies. Congratulations. It's just a very, very nice romantic film. And I hesitate to call it a rom-com because that has certain connotations that this, you know, doesn't have, I'm pleased to say. Yeah, Jennifer, the leads are so well-defined and have such unique characters. And it makes me wonder if they were based on anyone you know.
Oh, that's such an interesting question. They're really not. I think, you know, the book is even more focused on Hadley. And I really just started with the idea of two people who were both reluctant to fall in love and mistrustful of love for their own reasons, and wanted to see what happened when you put them together on a 7-hour flight. And so they're sort of, I think anytime you're writing characters that you steal bits and pieces from people you know and from life experiences, and the whole setup actually was because I had a long chat with somebody on a plane once, and then we got separated at customs, and I thought how interesting it was that you could spend so much time talking to somebody and then never see them again. When I write, as I write each draft and as I get further into a book, the characters always become just really completely themselves. And I think the film adds a whole another layer of uniqueness to them, of course, too.
Yes. But I mean, his obsession with numbers is a constant. You never let it drop. Did you have to watch for that, like structure? I guess structurally.
I just thought it was interesting to have a character who was so reliant on data and psychology and statistics, and to the point where it was hard for him to show any kind of vulnerability because that he let that get in the way of connection. And it was actually a really fun part to write in the book, because it was, you know, I was sort of making up statistics and studies, it was a really fun quirk of his character. And I think Katie Lovejoy, who wrote the screenplay, did a really nice job of weaving that through in the movie as well.
Yes. Jamil shows up every once in a while as a different sort of very practical person who you would believe would be in the scene, like a ticket taker, an airline stewardess, if that's what they call them now, sorry, a driver. I think that added, to me, that added a real bit of magic. It was like otherworldly, like a fairy godmother or something, but very modern. I loved that little bit of business. How did that happen?
I think that was really Katie Lovejoy, the screenwriter, who decided to make the narrator of the book into an actual personified fate character. And I think it's really fun and really elevates it. It's cool.
And you always go, oh, she's there. What important is she going to be sharing with them? She really has she's like the Greek chorus in a way.
Yeah.
So and that
the,
was
I mean, very... there's the story has so many themes of fate and timing, and to watch her kind of be the person nudging it along. There's a real kind of quirkiness to that. It's a really fun element, and I think it adds a lot to the story.
Over the next 6 hours and 47 minutes, Hadley Sullivan and Oliver Jones will fall in love.
This is me.
Well, this is unexpected.
I've always hated airplanes.
Then why are you on a 7-hour flight to London?
A wedding. You?
It's a bit complicated. Do you want to join me at the cinema? Make our first date dinner and a cheesy rom-com? Or is that like a third date thing for you? I'll
be reaching for you. Breaking all my rules for you.
The odds of finding your soulmate are slim to none.
This is my number. Text me so I've got yours.
Oh, no.
The odds of finding them again? Good luck.
So this experience more or less happened to you Jennifer.
Yes, the scenario. And I joke that I often take things that happen in my life and then add a romantic twist to them, because this was not a romantic story. But yes, I sat next to somebody on a plane and had a really long chat with them, and it stuck with me. It was years before I wrote about it, but I always just thought how interesting that was, and how easily we could
remember that so vividly.
Yeah, lose somebody. Exactly.
Yes. Now, Vanessa, you know, the characters look at each other and they say, this is like a rom-com, but not a cheesy rom-com. And of course, that's the problem with most rom-coms. They are ultimately cheesy. This one is not. And I'm wondering how you avoided that in directing the film.
I think it was about trying to keep a real balance between making it, I guess, a wish fulfilling and whimsical and playful, but also trying to ground it in some sort of reality and making sure that it's, that there was a real balance between those things. Also in the kind of emotional journeys of the characters as well, that when they land, where they are actually at, that we made sure that wasn't kind of skirted over or handled in a way that didn't give it space.
Absolutely. And also kudos for hiring Dexter Fletcher, who's one of my favorites, and Sally Phillips from Miranda. Great, great, great casting. I mean, I love the young leads, but I was just so thrilled to see those two there. Why did you hire them?
They are brilliant and funny, and they were up for it. I mean, they were so, and also Dexter's a massive director. So that was quite a funny little dynamic, because he could have been a bit of a but he wasn't at all. He was so nice, and he was like, he rocked up and said, okay, what do you want me to do, boss? And I found that kind of really hilarious and sweet. And then we also had Rob Delaney, who was just amazing and funny. Yeah. And we got really lucky with our cast.
Yes, and the two young people are spectacular. They really hold it in reality, you know, rather than spinning off into space as some do. And also, it's so much fun to see parts of London we don't normally see. So
yeah, good.
Kudos to that. Well, thank you so much, ladies, and best of luck with the picture and more book sales, I hope. And we'll see you next time.
Thank you so much.
How's your flight?
Surprising.
I lost his number, but I need to find this guy that I met on the plane.
Sounds really stupid.
Sounds brave.
With miles and miles between them, there is only a 0.2% chance that they will ever see each other again. But what good is a chance if you don't take it?
Are we going to talk about her?
She could be anywhere, but I can't stop thinking about her.
You won't find her just sitting here.
Is everything all right?
I have to go. I didn't see this coming.
Love is a lot of work.
It makes no sense.
It's not supposed to.
Is it better to have had a good thing and lost it, or never to have had it?
Are you like a tech bro, or?
I'm studying statistics at Yale.
Subtle status drop there.
British, you know, I can't help myself.